Hello. So as I said on my Instagram, I'll do my Stranger Things VFX breakdown after 100 subscribers, and we reached 100 subscribers. Thank you everyone for that. And this is part one. Part two will be coming soon, where we model Vecna's palace. And let's dive into the VFX breakdown. This is shot one, where I first line the camera with F-spy by taking one frame of the footage, match the perspective, then bring F-spy file into Blender. As everything lined up, I just modeled stuff by adding same image as background in Blender. It's so dark, so I just modeled simple geometry to match with the rocks, and with the proportional editing, I added details and also added some extra edge loops for extra details. Now the ground. I used displace modifier to make a ground, and again did some extra tweaking with proportional editing to match better with the reference. And I assign vertex group to this middle row, so they are not affected by the displace modifier. And where she is walking, I don't need to make changes on each frame. After that, I added a cube with a volumetric scatter node, plug into the volume for fog and red glow in the fog. For that, I added 4-point light on different strength and tweaks the fog with noise texture and color ramp to get the scary foggy look. For this shot, I just filmed legs because it was a close-up shot. Then, as before, I displace the ground with displace modifier and apply it so I can get better idea where the fades are going, and I can match the ground with that. And I animated the camera and footage moving forward, so nothing looks fake or cut off frame. And I edited the ground as she walking, so it's look like she's putting her feet on the ground. This is the problem I get because of the different perspective, and I don't have enough info to match that. Then I modeled the rocks around and added two cubes, one with less fog in the front and one with the high fog in the back. Added some point light and make them glow red so we get that scary look. To give more life to the scene, I imported some grass into the scene and added them into the collection. Then added hair particle to the ground, and in a render select those grass collection we just made, and after some tweaking we get some cool grass in our scene. They look less randomized, so I just randomized them and then weight painted the ground, so I'll get the grass only in the visible area. And that's it. Hope you enjoy the video. See you in the next one. Bye bye.